guys, what is going on? It is Obadiah, and today we are back on the center. So I was thinking today, we need to go out and find... What is she doing here? Get out of here. We need to go out and find some new cool stuff to tame. I'm making up some narcos right now. And they should... So they're starting to get done. We need something that gathers berries, because right now I've been out gathering berries by hand. And let me tell you, it is a huge pain, especially look at this. Look how sparse the plants are here. So it's been awful. So we need a berry gatherer and we need a flyer. Those are kind of like the two most important things. Some kind of carno would be great. We have the wolf, but something a little better would be nice. So we're making up these so we can make us some tranks. And then we're going to go out and see what we can find. I also need to make some bolas in case we run across a Terra. Let's see. What do we need for the bolas? Hide and stone. Oh, where's all my hide? Must be in the smithy. Okay. Let's do this so we can move. Grab some hide and make some bolas. How many do we need? 10? Alright, so I'm gonna go ahead and let some of this stuff craft up, get some bolas going, get some, narcotics and get some more tranks going, and then I'll bring you guys back when we are on our way out. All right, guys, we have got a Terra straight ahead of us. It is a level 150 something. So let's go ahead and see what we can do here. That should be just fine to get us by. Now let's hear this. Let's get right in the head. I can't see anything. That was not in the head. There we go. One. That's two. Three. Four. Are you gonna go down? Okay, it's down, it's down, it's down, it's down. Okay. Ugh. Bugs. Bugs everywhere. Okay, we can get a little... We can use a little bit of chitin, though. That's not bad. Come here. Don't you run from me. Okay, so I believe we... Because we don't... Do I have any prime on me? No, okay. Let's see if we can. If there's anything close by that'll get us prime. But for now... Well, we don't need to throw that much on there. Transfer? No, transfer half. Okay. Let's go ahead and throw this on. The problem with Terras is I do think they lose Topor fairly quickly. I'm gonna go ahead and go around. There's gotta be prime around here somewhere. A mammoth, maybe? I saw some mammoths going around. There's a Megaloceros. Oh, there's a Parasaurotherium right there! That could be all the prime we could ever want. Oh, and it's 84. We could totally take the guy out. Let's do it! Oh, and there's a dire bear. Ooh, what level's a dire bear? Because we could... A dire bear would actually be really useful right now. I think it's a little too low. Let's go for the Parasaurotherium. All right. Whoa, 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 whoa. What are we thinking? If we're going to get all the prime we need in the world... Where's our Pterodon? Pteranodon. If we're going to get all the prime we need, let's not... Put the meat on this guy. Let's wait for the prime. We'll let him starve a bit. Alright. Let's go take this sucker out. This is the one. This is the right one, right? Because I know there were two, and one of them may have been a higher level. But this 84 should not be a problem. We should be able to take him out, no problem. So, let's do it. Hopefully it's quick and easy and painless. And we can get all the prime we want. Okay. So I figure, why tame one Pteranodon when you can tame two? This guy's a little bit higher level, but it wasn't too hard to knock them out, but the colors on this guy are really awesome. So might as well get both going. I think we got enough prime off that Parasaurotherium to do two. Oh, only took three shots. Okay. So let's see. Where's the other one? It's right here. And this one's a little bit higher of a level, so now we have a backup. Eventually we'll get a real good Terra, but I think I read that a level 360 only needs 16 prime meat. Where is he? I believe. I'll have to look it up in the calculator just to make sure, in case we need to get more prime meat. But now it's just a waiting game, so I'm gonna go ahead and wait for these suckers to tame up, Now I'll bring you all back. Oh wait, what's this one? No, pretty much the same. Okay. So I'll let these guys tame up. Alright guys, so while we are here waiting on these Pteranodons to tame up, there is a level 72 Doedicurus, which is pretty low level, but we could really use one. And plus, not going to hurt to get more stuff. We're going to be using a lot of stone, and so let's go ahead and knock this sucker out. There, I think, a little bit longer of a tames. Ooh, I wonder if I can safely trap him right here. Let's try this. The more things we tame at once, the better. It saves us a lot of time in the long run. And, oh. Is he stuck? Oh. My arrows are stuck for some reason. Saves us a lot of time in the long run, and just kind of pushes us forward, you know? Okay, this is not good. My arrow's getting stuck right there. So I want to hit him in the head, because he has that protective shell that Doedicuruses have. It shouldn't take this that many arrows. I've got another 24, so that should be more than enough. Come on, go to sleep. But where's my other guys? I'm taming. I want to keep them close. Okay, there's the Pteranodon I'm taming. And there's my wolf. And there's the other Pteranodon. Okay. Go to sleep! Killing me, bud. Luckily, these guys are pretty slow, so this is not too... Oh, there we go. Run away, yeah. So it's not too much of a challenge. It looks like we're gonna update the server in a minute, so we gotta hurry up and get this sucker done. Alright, and it's down with two arrows left. So we're gonna throw the stuff on him and let these suckers tame up. And then we have to take on the Pteranodons and let all this stuff happen, and I'll bring you guys back when stuff starts to finish. Alright, any second now, this first guy should be popping up. In about 2.5 more food. There's one more prime meat on him, which should cover it, because he's right at the line. We'll go ahead and have our first Pteranodon. And there he is! Awesome! Alright, so let's put him on passive, but leave him on follow. Let's go check on the other sucker. So we got one coming up, and let's check this one out. Okay, he's got a little bit of time left, but not a whole lot. So we're ahead and wait for him to be done, and then I'll bring y'all back. All right, this guy is gonna take his last bite in just a second here. And it looks like he'll come out as level 3, so oh, there he goes, 3, what'd he come out as? 321, awesome. So now we're just waiting on that Doedicurus to tame up, and then we should have all sorts of good stuff. All right, and the last one is up, so all we gotta do now is get all these guys back to base, and then I will bring you guys back. It might be a little bit of a long walk and a little dangerous, but it should be okay. All right, guys, we are back at base. We did run into a little bit of a problem on the way home. We ran into a couple wolves, and they aggroed a Paraceratherium, and that actually killed our lower level Pteranodon. This guy almost died too, but I've already healed him up. So we need to go ahead and make saddles for that guy and for the Doed. I've already learned both Engrams, so let's see what we can do. I believe you make the Pteranodon saddle in your inventory, and I already have everything here. Let's go ahead and make one of those. And then the Doed saddle you do in the smithy. So, oh, what are we short on? Stone, okay. Let's grab a bit of stone. And what do we got? Doed saddle. Okay, awesome. So let's go ahead and saddle both these guys up. And ugh, crafting time is so slow. Okay. Put a little more level into fortitude. And then let's go ahead and get these suckers done. Okay, Doed saddle. Awesome. So this guy will help us get a lot more stone quickly. We're gonna need it because with the Castles, Forts, and Keeps mod that we're running on the server, we're going to need a lot of stone and a lot of raw metal too. So I think next order of business is we're going to need to get an Enki, and we're going to need to get a... Why can't I access this guy? Maybe I need to be outside. And we're going to be getting something to gather berries, because we need to make more narco berries, and doing it by hand is awful. There we go. All right, let's check this guy out. That did not work. And we're airborne. Awesome. So I think I'm going to spend a little bit of time leveling this guy up. It's going to be tough, because there's so many high-level things, but also kind of scout around the area, see what spawns are close that we can look at. All right, so we spent some time leveling up this Pteranodon. Got a few levels on him. Got some meat and let some of it spoil. And went and gathered up some narco berries, so now we have some more narcotics crafting. So I don't want to have to pick the narco berries by hand anymore. And looking around, kind of seeing what is around here, the best bet, I think, is just going to be to get a mammoth. They're not the best berry gatherers in the world, but they are close by. And I think this one's probably the closest. Ooh, there's a Gigantopithecus. Nice. We don't need that right now. Let's see, where's the closest one? That's a rhino. I think I saw this. Is this the 108 that I saw? Yeah, so that one might be the one, unless there's any right down this cliff. Ooh, there is. What level is this guy? He must be a fresh spawn, because I just flew down here not long ago. 84, that'd be a little easier to tame. But I'm going to go ahead and let these narco berries craft up and make some more arrows and whatnot. It's going to be a while to tame, so I might just get the level 84 and start with that. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and get everything set up, and then I will bring you guys back so we can knock this sucker out. Alright, so our 108 ended up getting killed by a high-level wolf, so I think we're going to go for this guy here. He's a level 120, so it's slightly better. The problem is, there's two of them here, and if I attack one, the other one's going to get aggroed. What's going on over there? Okay. So let's see if we can lead one of them off the cliff, and then that'll free it up. Come on, bud. Then that'll free the other guy up for us to trap somewhere. Oh, it doesn't look like they're aggroing together, which is great. But either way, we'll knock him off the cliff. A little closer. Oh, he's de-aggroed. Okay. Come on. Oh, let me out. Just a little closer. That is one benefit of being over here near the edge of the world. Easy to take care of high-level things you don't need to deal with right now. And see you later. Now he just falls forever to his death. Alright, so let's go ahead and aggro this one and bring him a little closer to base. Just, I think it'll be a little safer, and I think there's some good places for us to stand to shoot in safety here. So I'm gonna go ahead and lead him up here, and then we'll start shooting. Alright, so as I was leading those guys back to base, I did see there are some new ones that have spawned over here, which are way better. So we've got this guy. Nope, not that one. That's the garbage one. Where's the high level one? There were two. Oh, that must be him right there. So we got this guy, the 228 Enki, and I think there was a 240 mammoth. There's the 228. 240. So, since they're so close together, it might be a little challenging. I made an extra crossbow and went and made a ton more trank arrows. It took a little bit of time, and now we should be good to go if we can get these guys separated. Looks like they're kind of dispersing a little on their own, but let's go ahead and attack this one and try to lead them off. See if we can do it without aggroing. Oh, see, but now they're both aggroed. If we can just drop him right off this ledge and have the other one de-aggro, that'd be perfect. Come on. It's a little bit closer. The thing is, we want to make sure we don't have both of them drop off the edge, and that's going to be the hard part, I think. So let's do this and have them turn this way. Oh, no, we want to keep the 240. This tree is causing me problems. Come on. Oh! No one, stop! Okay. Oh, I thought he was off the edge for sure. He like walked right back up. Okay, I'm not sure how we're gonna do this. Because they are both angry. We might just have to just try to knock them both out? That's really unnecessary. We don't need two of them. Okay, is the one in the back... Okay, the one in the back is the one we need to get knocked off. Okay, perfect. Right here. So let's hit him. And now by the time the other one gets turned around, make sure he stays aggroed, this guy will be off the edge. Come on. And no, come on, this way. All the way. And there he goes. Awesome. So now we're free to trank this dude over here. And look at that, he's right where we want him. Okay, hopefully this won't take too many shots. Like I said, I made a ton of extra darts, but... And an extra crossbow. But nonetheless, it's still probably going to take quite a few. The runaway mechanic is probably the worst mechanic they've ever put in the game. I don't know why they do it. It seems to get worse with every update. We put maybe, I don't know, 20 arrows into this guy? He's looking a little bloody, which makes me nervous. I haven't tamed one of these guys since vanilla, I think. Is he aggroed to my other stuff, or is he running away? Please don't be aggroed to my other things. I don't know why he would do that. Okay, no, he's just running. But any time now, he should be going down. Got him down, and I put up a kind of a little bit of a half gate, half wall thing around him here, simply because I ran out of materials and trying to make it, but it should protect him a little bit. I haven't put any berries in his inventory yet because I need to go and gather them, but it's probably going to be quite a while for this guy to tame up. It has been the longest tame ever. I've not spent this long on a tame since vanilla official servers. Like 2.5 hours or something like that to tame it on regular berries. I also am taming an Enki back at the base because if I'm taming one thing for a long time, might as well tame two. But it's been so long I'm able to make myself flak. I've got a bunch of levels. I gathered a stupid amount of materials and made a dino pen. And, I guess we needed two more bites. What is it? What is a berry food? Is it 30 food? Something like that. So another 10 food and it should be good to go. And we'll have a level 350 mammoth. We didn't even look at the stats on this guy, but I bet it's gonna be so awesome. And where are we at? Okay, was this it right here? Tame up. Tame. Really, one more. Luckily, this guy's food does drop pretty quick. I mean, he had to eat something like 217 mejos or something like that, which is just kind of insane. But, well, you know, is what it is. And we'll have a cool mammoth. And honestly, he's going to be outdated probably in like 3 days. And we're going to need to get some better stuff and all that. But at the very least, we will have this guy. And he's pretty cool. I haven't had a reason to tame a mammoth for a long, long time. And now I do. And this has got to be right here. Oh, we got him! All right, passive. And we already went and made a saddle. So let's go ahead and put that on him. Oh, it's in his inventory. And don't follow me. And let's ride! Oh, yeah. Okay, so we gotta get rid of these gates. Oh, I wanna see, can he actually go through these, this size gate? No, dang it. Sorry, we had our dino pen out of this size gate, unfortunately. So let's just demolish this stuff, because I don't really need to pick it up, because I'll not ever need it again, honestly. And since we're advancing so quickly now, if I did ever make another pen like this, which I'm sure we probably will at some point, I wouldn't make it out of wood. I would make it out of stone, but we just didn't have the resources to go ahead and do that. So I'm gonna go ahead and demolish this and bring y'all back. Check it out, we already got 3,000 wood, 500 thatch, 300, oh, so much easier, 300 narco berries. Let's look at his statistics, 9,500 health, 2,300 stamina. We're not gonna breed him, so we don't care about oxygen to food. 920 weight, 414 melee, and 222 speed. I'd like to get, I'd like to get his health up to 10,000, but it's already at 11. Stamina, how's the stamina drain? Let's take a look. Oh, it's not too bad. We'll leave it alone. We want weight up, and after, I think we're gonna just wait to maybe 1,000 and then do a bunch in speed. But for today, guys, I do think that is gonna be it. If you did enjoy the video or if you learned something, do me a favor and hit that thumbs up button. And of course, always feel free to subscribe if you haven't done so yet, because why wouldn't you? Also, you can hit me up in all the social medias, your Twitters, your Facebooks, Instagrams, even Google Plus, even though no one ever uses it. And I do have a new Patreon site if you want to go check that out. It's at patreon.com/ObadiahX, which is how you can find me anywhere. With just Google ObadiahX on stuff. It's cool. But for now, guys, I really do appreciate you coming to hang out with me. And until next time, I will see you later.